Myself Supriya Pasnur, working as an assistant professor in civil department from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today's class, we are going to discuss on building permission. These are the learning outcomes. At the end of this session, the learner will be able to impart the knowledge of the building permission and its procedure. These are the documents which are needed for the building permission. First is the application form or the notice. Second, the information in the notice. So whatever the information is accompanied in the notice, as per that the attachments has to be done. In that you have the ownership, the title and the area. Second is the plans to be submitted with the application. In this it consists of the key plans, the layout plans and the measurement plans. Next you have the fees and the charges. In that the development charges and the labor charges are come into consideration. The no objection certificate from any department like the railways, smoke nuisance or the defense department, etc. Supervision has to be considered, which supervision of the engineers or the architect. They will be filling the form in the appendix B1. Next is the drawing sheets and the coloring of the plans. The drawing sheets or the coloring, that means the number of the copy of the drawings has to be submitted. At least four plans or four copies of the drawings has to be submitted. The signing of the plan. And finally, you have the qualification and the competency of the architect and the engineer. So this is the building permission and the procedure. So first of all, you have to register an architect or an applicant with an application form. He comes into the, he fills the information given in the appendix form A1. The form is needed for the construction purpose, whether you want to develop any construction or redevelopment any construction, or if you want to carry out any alterations or demolishing of the structure. So this form is necessary to be filled through an architect or an engineer or a supervisor. Also, it should be submitted to an licensed authority as it is in the prescribed form. And next you have to submit the supporting documents as per the checklist that is defined in the checklist, which declaration for the relaxation and the required NOCs. So the defined checklist, it consists of some of the documents which are mandatory and optional. So the in the mandatory documents you have the tax receipt, or if you have any Satbara extract, and also the measurement plan, it should be certified one. So these are the mandatory documents. So those documents which are mandatory has to be attached along with the form. So after that your application will be registered if the documents are as per the list. So after the application registration, you have the payment. Each payment before scrutiny. Scrutiny is nothing but the processing fees. So here the scrutiny level, it is the proposal of this. You can see here that it is divided into two levels. So one level of scrutiny is carried out by the assistant town planner, and the second scrutiny is done by the chief officer of the municipal council. So here the assistant town planner, he verifies the documents which were uploaded, and next after the verification is successful, so he has to fix the schedule of the site visit date. So he himself goes to the site. Here you can see that the enter the site visit reports and receive the NOCs from the department. So the engineer or the assistant town planner himself goes to the site and he verifies the drawings over there, and he fills in the questionnaires drafted for the site of the building permission. So whatever the drawings, actually he will make a consolidated scrutiny as it is based on the comparison of the layout drawings and the proposal details. So after this, he will generate the report. The generation of the report based on the town planner client and the application dates and the site visit reports. So as per that, the report will be generated, and after the verification, after the inspection is over, the report will be generated. And if the proposal is up to date or after the approval of the site, so the next you have the submission of the proposal proposal goes to the CO, that is the chief officer, for the rejection or the approval. So here you can see that the approval from this, after submission, it is the work is carried forward to the CO. So the CO, he re-verifies the documents again, whatever the report or whatever the town planner reported, he just cross checks it once again whether they are up to the mark or not. Means the verification of the reports is done, and whatever the remarks were there of the assistant town planner, he re-verifies again. And after the re-verification, you see that the CO will check whether the relaxation is any relaxation or a concession required, or whether to allow any relaxation or the concession for the proposal. So as per that, this is carried for further. If the relaxation is yes, so here you can see that the front margin and the parking violence, it goes to that. And then if the relaxation is not allowed, you go for he accepts the proposal. So from that, after accepting the proposal of the approved plan, here you can see that the calculations of the development and the premium charges are there. So the applicant has to pay the development charges and the labor charges before the approval of the plan. That is next you have, after that you have the send notification for the payment of the charges. So after the post payment, here comes the notification of that. So the client has to go further for the online payment or the RTGS. So after doing the online payment, the verification of the payment is again done. He verifies the payment of it, and then after the verification of the payment is done successfully, the CO approves the plan, and he digitally sign the building permission certificate. So after the once the CO signs the building permission certificate, the applicant can now finally print the building permission certificate. Here which is contained in the appendix D1. So the overall procedure of the building permission procedure, right from the application to the certificate to the approval of the plan, it takes around 30 days for this procedure. So here you can pause the video for 2 minutes. So can you give the answer for this? What is scrutiny? So this is the answer for that. Scrutiny is nothing but the questions are raised over there. Is the location as per the layout of the town and the country planning department? Whether it is yes or no, and if any remarks are there, you have to specify over here. And even the verification of the boundaries as per the plan and as on the ground position, if tally or not tally, and remarks if any, you can write over here. And the ownership of the approach road, and whether you have any trees on the site, or next is, are the trees going to be demolished when the construction is going on, or is there any proper ventilation or the sanitation on the site? Is the site within the vicinity of the structure identified by the archaeological department? So these are the scrutiny questions asked over there. So here you can pause the video for 2 seconds. So just here comes the question that in the building permission procedure, once the documents are verified from the assistant town planner, next is, you have below the options as, first is the application registration, second is the schedule of the site visit date, third is the online payment, and fourth is the none of the above. I think you have got the right answer for this. The schedule of the site visit date. So you have seen in the last building permission procedure slide that after the documents are verified from the assistant town planner, so he himself decides the site visit date. So this is what the answer is. So these are the references. Thank you.